Hi there, Capricorn. Welcome to your monthly intuitive reading for August. Let's see what might be on the cards for you. Getting started with the sacred power reading cards, guys. I will be going to the Work Your Light Oracle, drawing you a lead tarot energy from the Moon Child Tarot before heading across to the Rider Waite and Star Child Tarot for the tarot positions. You can find me on Facebook, Instagram, and on TikTok, guys. The links are always below the video, including the link to my website should you want to arrange a personal reading or healing for yourself, or learn tarot with me through the initiation, which I have just launched, which is my 4-week immersive learn tarot journey, which you can join at any time. Okay, here we go. Davis, now I've just had this for Scorpio. This is about celestial beings that might be working with you to guide you here on the earth plane. So these celestial beings, you know, there is the law of free will here on the earth plane. They can't directly interfere, but they can send you guidance, which often comes through the synchronicities, the angel numbers, your own intuition. So we want to pay, even more attention to those things this month. Next one out was abundance. Beautiful. I absolutely love this card. So some of you might be experiencing abundance on a greater scale this month. And, you know, abundance isn't just limited to money and resources. It could be an abundance of happiness, an abundance of love or intimacy. But some of you might be getting new opportunities or also increasing your financial position in some way. Oh, yes. Just say yes. So if there is an opportunity that you are looking at, Capricorn, maybe it is an investment, maybe it is a new job or a new business venture, the cards are saying just say yes, because this is going to lead to abundance for you. It could be in love as well, right? Abundance of all the good stuff that comes along with that. And generally with this oracle card, it says don't overthink it. Right? Otherwise, the ego can put up limitations. Oh, we can't do that because we need to relocate, or we don't have what it takes, or all these kinds of things. So it says, feel into it, right? Feel into that intuition. If it feels right, then do it. So if you did come to this reading with a question on your heart that you wanted a yes or no answer to, that could just be the green light, Capricorn, for you to be able to move forward. Let's get your lead tarot energy. One card, please, for the Capricorn Collective to sum up the energy of August. I'm going to go for that one that is calling me. It is the King of Cups. Okay, Scorpio energy for me. You might be dealing with a Scorpio. You might be getting this offer from a King of Cups character in your life, right? It's King energy. So whether it's male or female, it's somebody who is quite mature in maybe like a position of authority over you. So it could be a boss, a mentor, a manager, father-in-law, or something like that. They could be giving you some really good advice on a decision, whether to go for it or not. And you can trust the King of Cups, guys. This is somebody who is also very intuitive, very compassionate, and really has your back. Really has your back. So, yeah, I'm really feeling that. And some of you may need to integrate the qualities of the King of Cups yourself, you know, being emotionally intelligent, grounded, empathetic, and all of those things as you go about making this decision this month. Okay, Capricorn, let's get out the energy of the recent past. Okay, well, I'm taking that sun energy, guys. That is also a very strong yes card in the tarot. There are some cards that are yeses or nos. So it's saying that you really are moving into quite a blessed chapter, and it could come through whatever this opportunity is. Page of Pentacles was at the bottom of the deck at the same time. Let's get your biggest challenge to moving ahead or accepting or finding this opportunity. King of Wands. Leo energy for me. advice, the moon, Pisces energy. Whoops. Sometimes they fall on the ground and start really twisting in my hands. Okay, let's get the outcome for you. There we go. Nine of Pentacles with Justice. Love it. Okay, let's get the clarifiers that can provide the extra layer of information, can change the meaning slightly as I read these as pairs. The Magician. Wow. Five of Wands and Three of Cups in the Challenge. Pisces, we've got the Two of Cups, Six of Wands, beautiful. I'm going to get one more for that Two of Cups, Ace of Pentacles. Okay, here we go. Okay, guys, so yeah, there is a new opportunity blooming for you this month. For some of you, it's in romantic love, and for others of you, it may be in the workplace. I keep these pretty open, guys. They are general readings, so it's good to, read them in multiple directions so that they do resonate for you. So I feel like you are going to get this opportunity or offering or some advice on it from this King of Cups character that just keeps coming through for me. But of course, you are the one that is going to need to take action here. That's what the cards are saying. And I feel like for some of you, you already know what this opportunity is, but you've been mulling it over. You're not too sure. Am I all in? You know, do I really want to, you know, shore it up with this person and kind of enter into a commitment? Or do I really want to, you know, accept this job or start this business, whatever it is, because there's a sense that, you know, you are going to really need to, you know, invest a lot of time, effort and energy into it. And then the cards are saying, yes, the Sun is saying, wow, it looks pretty bright ahead, guys. You know, maybe you should plant those seeds because they are going to grow. So with the Magician, it's saying, you know what, you have everything within you, Capricorn, to make a really good goal of this. You're in a really good position. You have the resourcefulness of all the resources of the Pentacle. You have the intellect of the Sword, the passion, power, potential of the Wand, and the emotional intelligence or the advice from the Water sign, the Cup. So the Sun says, you know what, you have overcome some really big obstacles in your life, or you have really worked to get yourself in a position where either this person has come in or this opportunity has come your way. I feel like, you know, it's through your past experiences that has kind of positioned you as a likely candidate, that sounds bad in love, but you know what I mean, for this opportunity. And now it's, I've got this kind of, I'm hearing it's your time to shine, or it's your time to receive, right? Maybe you have been trying to manifest this for a while. Excuse me, you might have been kind of going on your own journey as well. A journey to work on your shadow side, to raise your vibration, all of the things that the Magician does in order to draw to him or her the opportunities that, you know, they are desiring. So, well done. In the challenge position though, yeah, yep, there's always a flip side, isn't there? Three of Cups, a Five of Wands, and the King of Wands. Okay, one of the things I'm seeing as the challenge here is you're kind of questioning your ability to step up into this, to like become, you know, a king energy yourself, whether you're male or female. This is like, well, in order to like go into a commitment with this person, or in order to take this role, or you know, whatever it may be, I'm going to need to, you know, step into king energy. I'm going to need to take on a lot of like accountability, responsibility. I'm going to need to really bring that energy to this. No more, you know, maybe partying or being in your page or night energy, you know, okay, I can commit to this for this week and then I'm out. This is really about stepping up and really, really committing. And putting your energy into it. So Five of Wands for me can sometimes be a card of energy leaks. So you might be wondering, you know, can I actually give the energy to this that is really required to grow it. Three of Cups, you know, to take those seeds of the new, that Ace of Pentacles that's coming up, and really expanding it into abundance of love, abundance of money, abundance of opportunity, right? So really the cards are saying you need to be that King of Wands, somebody who is stepping up in authority, somebody who is connecting with their energy, power, and purpose, and really investing in this with really, you know, strong vision and clarity. Excuse me, guys. You know, it's really saying that you have this energy of discernment with you this month. So I think that you will know that, hey, this is actually probably pretty much too good to turn down. So I'm going to have to get over those challenges basically and go for it. Because in the advice from Tarot, I have the Moon, the Two of Cups, and the Ace of Pentacles. So I feel like there is another party involved, whether this is in business or love for you. There is a sense that, you know, you're really coming together with someone that you can make magic with, you can build abundance with, right? That you can really make a go of this with. Could be a Pisces. And I feel like they are, you know, there is a person involved who is offering you this opportunity or giving you advice on it, but it's showing up as the Ace of Pentacles, this opportunity. So in a love situation, this would be somebody who we can have a solid commitment with, right? Somebody who's not mucking around, not wanting to just have some fun. This is somebody that, like, you know, they're in it for the long haul, or they're in it to see where it goes in terms of security and stability. So this is why you need to be in that King energy, because they are going to, you know, demand that same of you. So it can be an existing relationship going to engagement, going to marriage, and you're going to be left with, well, can I meet this challenge? But yes, you can. In, you know, the workplace, this can be that new next level of responsibility, team leader, supervisor, manager. If it's in business, you know, finally, you know, maybe getting that business partner and setting up with them. With the Moon, a couple of things here. It does say that this is a hidden blessing, this opportunity, right? That there's a sense of soulmate energy or twin flame energy when these two cards come in together. It's also saying make sure that you listen to your, you know, your deeper subconscious and your intuitions. Again, Davis, the information that might be coming through from source, because the Moon can talk about, you know, insight coming through that channel that helps you find that path ahead. It can be a card of, you know, undercurrents or things happening below the surface. Just make sure that you do obviously look at it from all angles and get the information that you need before going ahead. But I am feeling more the hidden blessing of this Moon energy here. So it could most definitely be dealing with a Pisces as well. Yeah, I feel that Six of Wands, Nine of Pentacles, and Justice, what I'm feeling that might be that kind of challenge that I've been feeling in this is that this is kind of like justice time over your being a bit of a lone wolf, lone ranger kind of energy. So for example, this could be somebody amazing that's come in a relationship, but you were quite happy single, you were really in your energy and you had made peace with that, and then all of a sudden someone comes in and this is the justice, this is the change that shifts you into a different status here. That's what I'm really feeling with that. Because the justice energy, guys, is about a big change coming into your life that can bring you abundance, because the Nine of Pentacles is such an abundant energy. It's somebody who is living with a sense of quality and luxury, feeling good, looking good, and just attracting so much more of that into their life as the Magician would. And the Six of Wands says, you know what, Capricorn, this is the victory that you have been waiting for while you were going through those darker times, working on your shadow side, overcoming those obstacles. Finally, you know, I'm being recognized here. I've been seen by, you know, a beautiful soulmate. There's a sense of somebody recognized that energy in you and wanted to connect with you because of that. These are energies of being seen in your glory and being magnetic and attractive, and it's the justice that brings the karmic balancing to your life and takes things to the next level. Guys, I'm not even going to say any more about this. It looks like a very blessed direction that you're heading in, one of love and abundance. So I wish you all the best with it if this is your reading. Do keep in mind it is a general reading, guys. It can't possibly resonate for everybody, but feel free to drop me a comment if it does. I do read them all and try to interact with you all over there as well. Helps me get to know you guys and connect with your energy. I am wishing you so much love and magic for the month of August, guys. See you back here for plenty more readings. Bye for now.